Well, hey guys, Bella Rose from Tech City back again with your news update on NSARS. The Lagos State Panel of Inquiry and Restitution on Police Brutality has begun sitting, and we've got details on how you can join the stream. Also, the Lagos State Employment Trust Fund is beginning to gather data of businesses affected by the destruction caused by hoodlums around parts of the city. The CEO of Samsung has passed away. We've got details about that, and you would not believe the beautiful chain reaction of one tweet from McDonald's. Also, iPhone 12 has launched in China. Details of that after this. Now, following demands made by Nigerian youth during the NSARS protests, which was setting up an independent body to oversee the investigation and prosecution of all reports of police brutality and misconduct, the Lagos State Judicial Panel of Inquiry and Restitution has begun sitting. Its three times a week sittings will be streamed online, according to musician and lawyer Files the Bad Guy, who tweeted days ago, "I will definitely be attending their sessions and following every step of the way. We are closely watching this time around. Zero mago-mago. We also have people that will make sure proceedings must always be broadcast live for everyone to watch." On Twitter, at Lagos SARS panel streamed live its sitting via Periscope on Tuesday, and Arise News also broadcast the sitting on its official YouTube channel, Arise News. We'll recommend that you follow on Twitter and on YouTube so that when the channels go live on the days of the sitting, you get notified. Now back to the panel seating. According to real-time updates via Twitter on Tuesday, filmmaker Editi F. Young said the panel started almost 2 hours after schedule, and at the end of the seating he attended, a number of the cases were adjourned until further notice, and that the panel reportedly retired for the day. The seating lasted a little over 1 hour, and it holds physically at the Lagos State Court of Arbitration in Lekki. The state governor, however, said people with complaints and petitions on incidents of police brutality could send their cases to the panel via email on judicialpanelonsars@lagosstate.gov.ng or call the numbers on your screen. Elsewhere, the Lagos State Government, through the Lagos State Employment Trust Fund, LSETF, is marshalling resources to offer assistance to business owners who took a hit. Now, the Trust Fund was in fact established to create jobs and tackle unemployment in Lagos, but now, in a tweet, the handle said, "Are you a Lagos-based business and your store got looted or vandalized during the curfew? LSETF is here to help." So make sure that you check out the link in the description box below and fill it. Social media handlers of iconic brands have teamed up in the most heartwarming, most unexpected way to drum up empathy and a community for social media handlers the world over. You might cry, so get some tissue. McDonald's handle started by tweeting on the 23rd of October, "It's always, when is the McRib coming back?" and never, "How are you doing, person who runs the McDonald's account?" And then the responses started pouring in. Adobe tweeted saying, "Starting a social media manager support group, let me know if you want to join." And then record company Atlantic Records tweeted, "Same here, sigh. It's always, listen to my mixtape or demo, and never, how are you Atlantic, or how's the dynamic duo who run Atlantic's account?" Facebook also got in on the fun by replying, "Honestly, same. No, I don't know when dark mode is coming out. Also, I'm fine, thanks." And Instagram also responded, "Felt that," sending all the love emoji, fries emoji, and burger emoji. Grubhub, which is kinda sorta in the same line of business with McDonald's, tweeted, "Our DMs are full of, you sent me utensils for four, but I ordered for one, but never, how was your day, Grubhub? And you know what? It hurts." HBO tweeted, "I have never felt more seen. Like, I don't know when House of Dragon is premiering." IBM then responded, "I feel you. It is always, when will IBM make computers again? And never, how's it going, social media person?" Oreo, the biscuit company, came on board and said, "We hear you. Everyone just wants to know when the cake star is coming back." While Pantene Pro-V tweeted, "Not us crying at the accuracy. It is always, why'd you get rid of that shampoo pump? And not doing anything fun this weekend? P.S. We are ready for Ronaldo to drop his hair care routine, they tweeted. Pizza Hut then tweeted, facts. Bring back the Proyatso, Bigfoot, Cheesy Bites. Wellness check on all social account managers. Uber Eats also came right in saying, I feel seen. Honestly, I wish I had a promo code to offer you all, but I don't. Brand Twitter is here for you. Xbox then said, if you ever feel bad about bummed, we're always here if you need to talk about anything. Anything. And then Zoom also responded saying, OMG, yes, like please don't at me if you are on mute. Shade. Saying also, can we be friends? Person who runs the McDonald's account would make the perfect combo meal. That was really sweet, if you ask me. Now, another not so sweet news. Lee Kun-hee, the chairman of South Korea's largest conglomerate, Samsung Group, has died at the age of 78 after having been in a coma for years. In a statement, Samsung said, all of us at Samsung will cherish his memory and are grateful for the journey we shared with him. According to Forbes, he was the richest person in South Korea with a net worth of about $17 billion as of August this year. The week of his death in China, the iPhone 12 launched with a line of people standing outside Apple's flagship shop in Beijing. This comes after its US launch, as some Chinese customers have said the iPhone 12 is a tribute to the classic iPhone 5S and that it's much lighter and thinner than other versions. Now, while the addition of 5G plays a small part in the iPhone 12's popularity, the decision of the company to remove earphones and chargers from the box is yet to make noticeable impact. And that's all we have time for today on your Tech City News Update. I'm Bella Rose from Tech City saying thank you very much for just being there for us, checking out the website, commenting on all our videos, and even more, subscribing. So please do all of that yet again. Follow us everywhere on YouTube, on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. And yeah, just interact with us. We love to hear from you. Till I come your way again next time, please stay safe and bye-bye.